Sierra Michelle TV, subscribe and like, please.
Don't take no shit, it won't be used. But I guess
who will I confine in? Who will I confine in?
Hey. I said fuck 'em.
Wish 'em well, then you duck 'em. Treat you like you nothing. Act like you won't touch them. I said, fuck them. Who will I confide in? Ooh. My makeup hasn't been this flawless in a minute, so I'm really happy. Starting the birthday prep off really good. Makeup is flawless. Don't worry about the eyelashes. I got some eyelashes, but I ain't putting them on today. I'm putting them on tomorrow. So I'm really happy with the makeup, and the hair is looking cute. I'm not taking my hair down. I need it all to grow out. So yeah. Okay, so right now I just made it to the nail shop, and I'm gonna try to bring you guys in there. I'm gonna see if they let me record. A good thing about my last shop, even though they charged a significant amount of, you know, much more money, they let me record, and I did all my nail vlogs in there. And like the one time I got my short white acrylic nails, if y'all haven't seen that video, check it out right now. The one time I got those nails, they like let me record the whole process, and that video actually has a few thousand views on it. You know, it's one of my good videos, so I hope they let me record. I'm definitely not shy about asking, so I'm gonna ask. I'm kind of mad that I have to wear a mask because I want to be safe, but I don't want to mess up my makeup. So I got a mask, I put it on, and I got some stuff to touch up my makeup with. But let's get in. And we're doing a walk-in, so I don't see a lot of cars out here. I'm hoping that I don't gotta wait too long. Even if I do, I'm gonna just go and get some food and come back. But let's see. We'll see what it's giving.
Okay, so,
don't take no shit, it won't be used. But I guess I'll be gone. Here's a make it so bad.
Girl, why my makeup is all type of messed up? So I'm about to fix my makeup real quick and I'm gonna show you guys my nails. Hold on right quick though, because I look like I've been in a fight. I gotta fix my makeup. Okay, hey guys, so I'm back. I tried to fix my makeup a little bit. It might be still messed up. I'll be back when we get our food and stuff. So it's really windy and noisy out here, so I'll be back.
Hi, I'm Rakisha. You're tuned into my channel, and today we're at a mafia restaurant.
Hey guys, good morning. So right now I just got some workout clothes on. I'm about to go get some coffee and then we're going to work out at home. I like to do my home workout in my like house. Then when we finish that, I want to get on the treadmill and get in the swing of running. So let's get started with our day. And while I'm drinking my coffee, I'm about to read a little of my Bible and just get my mood together, get my mind right, get my heart right, and just set my intentions for today to be productive and to just be on a good note. So I'm done. I'm done drinking my coffee. I done catched up, called my mom, called my grandmother, and yeah, I called my folks and I just, you know, said my good mornings and checked on everybody. And now, I'm about to put this workout. Y'all know I use LaToya Forever's workouts. But yeah, now I'm just going to work out and I don't want to work out. I'm very lazy, but it's just like, if I don't change, nothing's going to change. Like, I don't feel like I look how I see myself, how I know I'm supposed to look. All this extra weight and just going through being depressed and not taking care of myself, not taking care of how I look, how I appear. I'm not taking care of my house. Like, I just want to change on it. And I have to keep consistent. Like, if you saw my morning routine, you saw like the first day of me working out. Sorry, I'm like stuttering. But the first day of me working out this week was that day. This is the second day, so yeah, let's get into it.
Love you, Dre. So this is my post-workout snack for today. It's not too bad, but it's not like yummy. But it's on the healthier option. It has my proteins and stuff in it. So I'm gonna eat this, scroll on Instagram, then I'm gonna hop in the shower. Oh my God. Let's see how this. Woo! When I say I worked out, this was a good at home workout today. Oh my God. Woo. I'm really proud of myself. Doing okay. Working on the body. It's not perfect, but it's getting there. I'm getting healthy. You know, it sucks, but I like the feeling of progress. That looks so much better than that crap I've been wearing. I ain't gonna lie to you. So much more natural yet cute. So like recently I just been talking about like, why is it that like, and I need 3 pumps, but I'm gonna start off with 2. And before we get started, I'm gonna just put some of this on my face, some setting spray. It smells like freaking strawberries. Oh my God. Then I'm gonna get this setting powder by Kylie Cosmetics. Yeah, I'm gonna take this Kylie setting powder and just put a little on my face. It just kind of keeps me from getting too oily. But like recently I was talking to just my therapist and just different girlfriends just about like, why as women we stay in situations when we deserve so much more? Like, and I was just thinking about myself, period. Just, child, I don't even want to talk about my ex on any platform because I've done it too many times. I've talked about leaving the man. I talked about so much, and at the end of the day I will go back to him. At the same day I'll go back to him. At the end of my sentence I'm texting him.
Wait a damn minute.
What? So it's really sick. It's sick, you know. But this time I'm done. Okay. This time we're done. He's moved on. I've moved on and I don't want to go back. But I will say that I'm not the only one, only female like this. Like, a lot of the times we'll go back to a man just for comfort, comfortability. I just feel like that man was somebody that I was just used to and comfortable around and comfortable being with intimately too. Anyway, I just feel like we deserve to be loved. I deserve to be loved. I deserve to have that Ciara type of love. Ciara and Russell Wilson type of love. I don't deserve to just have anything. Like a man not putting in no effort. Like somebody told me this and I like the way he said it. He like, we were just talking like, how I meet you is how I treat you. That's what he told me. And I'm just like, how I meet you is how I treat you. So if a man meets you, let's say y'all meet in the club and y'all are intimate on the first night, is he gonna treat you like a woman or is he gonna treat you like, you know, like he's not interested, like he doesn't care about you, treat you any type of way? Now, granted, some people meet, some people have sex on the first night, all that good stuff, and they are in a lasting marriage, all that good stuff. Some people do, but most of the time, I feel like that's true. How you meet somebody is how they you set the tone for how they're going to treat you. So if we are first dating or whatever we're talking and I let you disrespect me, you're going to continue to do that because that's that learned behavior. That's that learned behavior. And you set the tone for how you want to operate. If somebody can see that they don't have to take you on a date, they don't have to wine and dine you, y'all can just meet up randomly and have sex, that's what the tone is going to be set as, you know? So, like, I was, like, running down my relationship timeline and just talking with my therapist about it and just trying to get to the root of why I keep going back to this man and why and how and all that good stuff. So for me, sometimes you can't even talk to friends or family. Like, I can't stand when I'm trying to explain something to someone and before I can get my sentence out, you're already interrupting me, giving me your whatever. And I'm just like, damn, I didn't finish. I did not finish. Sometimes, you know, friendships can be one-sided and people will constantly call you about their problems or about situations. And it's just like, damn, I'm going through stuff too, or I would like to talk about this, but every time I try to talk about it or every time I try to even get an inch in the conversation, you won't shut the hell up so I can get it out. So for me, it's just been good for me going to a therapist to just not hold everything in and not to feel so lost or so down. It really does help me. And I don't know, black people always frown on therapy and stuff, but honey, if I didn't have a therapist this year, like, I don't know where I would be, because I was bottling so much stuff in and I still am having a hard time of just opening up with her. But she's been like a lifesaver to me, little does she know. But I will say, like, when you start, like, loving yourself and talking, like, speaking life and stuff, when you say, like, I deserve love, like, one day I kept saying it, like, I deserve love. I deserve to go on dates. I deserve someone to treat me good. I deserve someone to love me, to, you know, love me in a way that I wanted to be loved, to, you know, different things. And I just feel like when I kept saying that, like, it kind of like came to me where, and I'm not gonna say my life is perfect, I'm in love, I'm not gonna say anything, but I'm single and I'm dating and I'm actually trying to practice loving myself and taking care of myself and not like being depressed and stuff, because, or managing it, work on managing everything. This year I probably only got dressed up 5 times. 3 of those times was for an interview. I've been in sweats and t-shirts this entire 2020. It's kind of sick. Imagine not dressing up or anything, or just, you know, just imagine looking how you feel for an entire year. That was me for an entire year. So now I'm just managing that, and I'm also just speaking life into my situation. And one day I was just telling myself, like, Sierra, you deserve love. You deserve love. You deserve this. You deserve it. You deserve it. And I think, like, that next week I went on a nice little date with a good friend. And I'm not going to say we're going to be together or anything like that, but I'm just saying sometimes, I mean, it felt good to get out, to go on a date, to kind of be treated good, and for you not to expect anything in return. I don't owe you nothing. You don't feel like I, you know, like, it just felt good. It was a good vibe. And I was just like thinking about life and how sometimes you deserve things and you need to just keep that in your mind. Practice those affirmations and just practice self-love and just believing that I deserve it. It's gonna happen. I deserve it. I don't know. Like, I don't know if that even makes sense, but for me, I was just kind of mind blown by that. And I was like, oh my God. I kept, like, looking back on it, I was like, okay, I kept saying that week. And then I turn around and we have a nice little date. It wasn't anything expensive, extravagant. It was a good time. I'm not gonna lie to y'all, we ate Applebee's. I picked out Applebee's 2 for $20. I'm not trying to break the bank for you, buddy. And I'm not trying to, like, use you or anything. I'm not gonna lie to y'all, I like a good little Applebee's. I'm busy after work. I don't got time to get dressed up and go nowhere. Let's just go to Applebee's and have a good time and drink and enjoy each other. And that's what we did. It was so simple. yet I got out the house and I just had a good time. Nothing was expected at the end of the night and we just enjoyed each other. So I'm about to contour. I'm not gonna lie to y'all, like, I'm ready to have somebody's child. Like, if somebody came to me, great job, and checked out everything on the list, a relationship with God, good, wholesome, family oriented, selfless. You gotta be selfless. You can't be all about yourself. If somebody came to me like that right now, I would have their child, okay? So, I mean, I'm single. I'm ready for love. Like India, I reset.
I am ready for love.
But at the same time, I'm just working on myself too and making sure I love myself and that I'm ready for someone like that to enter my life. Am I ready for that right now? I can't even manage keeping a clean apartment. I can't manage keeping myself up to like par as far as my how I'm presenting myself to the world. So I just think about those things and I just want to work on myself. I want to get some accomplishments under my belt. And yeah, I'm kind of happy right now. So for me personally, I'm happy right now. I'm dating, I'm single, I'm working on myself. And I will say that dating and having a relationship and stuff isn't the end all be all, but I do feel like God did intend for two people to be together. And that's why people go crazy when they be like in, like put in a hole in prison. Like, we're meant to like be with a companion and to be around people and to, you know, all that. So I feel like it's, people say it's not all that, and it's not all that. You still have stuff to do in the meantime, in between time. But I will say that I'm happy right now, and girl, life goes on. Life, you know, something isn't the end all be all. I will say I'm in my 20s. I just turned 25 not too long ago, and I'm just ready and looking forward to the next 5 years of my life. I'm happy that I haven't like went through my 20s chasing after a relationship that's not working out. That's something that I never wanted to do. I never wanted to just be comfortable in a bad situation. So I'm happy that it worked itself out and this was the outcome. I don't have any children from the relationship. I'm really happy that this was the outcome because I can move forward. I can better myself and change the trajectory of my life, because there's power in the tongue and there's power in your intentions. So when you set your intentions to be loved and to be loved in a specific way, I think that that will come to you.
Sing it again. God did it.
For me it's very important when I be feeling like I'm in a rut, when I be feeling so down and stuff, that I change what I'm listening to. I change the type of music I'm listening to. I'm not like perfect. I'm not, you know, I'm not gonna say that I'm perfect. I'm gonna tell you that I make mistakes. I started back cursing, you know. I'm not perfect, like, but I want to be genuinely. Y'all probably don't want to hear this, but I do want to be saved, you know. I do. I want to be saved. I want to be an example. I want to live a life like Christ, but I'm not perfect. But I want to strive and make changes and be honest with myself and be honest with people around me that I'm far from perfect, you know? And what makes me whole, what makes me feel good is when I listen to good, you know, uplifting gospel music, Christian music, when I go to church, when I'm around my community of believers, I feel better. I feel like my weeks are strengthened, as opposed to when I do things myself, when I try to get into relationships and be dating, when I try to be drinking and just kicking it or whatever. I don't feel good. I feel content, like contempt. I don't feel like, it just doesn't sit well with me. I was raised in church all my life. My grandparents are pastors and musicians, and we've always been in church my entire life. So that's my upbringing. That's what makes me feel like my purpose in life is to inspire people to live like Christ. That's what I feel like my purpose is to be young and saved and to inspire people to live like Christ. But I feel like a lot of the time people expect you to be perfect, or people be like ready for you to not be perfect. Like people be like, oh, you curse. Oh, she drinking. Do you drink? I'm not perfect. I never said I was perfect. I didn't just say, oh, I'm a Christian, so now I'm perfect. It's not like that. Just like people go to go to college to get an education, to like study, to get that those A's. I have to study to like, you know, I have to work towards being better, being a better person. And that's all I really want to be, a better person, a better me. So I just wanted to get on here and talk to y'all a little bit and show y'all like the real me and like a day in my life, a few weeks in my life or whatever. I just want to show you guys the real, raw and uncut. And I know y'all probably don't see this on YouTube, people talking about God, and that's okay. And in the same breath, I might do something that's not right. But God, you know, God sees all. He checking me, so you don't gotta check me, okay, boo? Okay. Who gonna check me? But yeah, getting back towards setting your intentions and just having a good day. So listening to good church music, my little gospel little playlist, it really does help me get through the day. And I stop feeling those feelings that I might be feeling, dealing with depression or just feeling sad or feeling like I'm still not where I want to be in life. It helps me. So don't get me wrong, I'm gonna listen to whatever I want to listen to. I definitely gonna cut on some Lil Kim, some NBA YoungBoy, some Nicki Minaj. I'm gonna cut them on. But I'm also gonna like try to balance it. I'm not gonna listen to all that. I might not listen to Layden Green, feeling, you know, myself. That's my song. Like, I got a sad playlist that I literally listen to, and it's not healthy, but I do. I got a sad playlist that I listen to when I'm sad. I'm not gonna listen to that all day. I'm not gonna listen to that today, okay? Because I don't want to be sad. I'm gonna listen to some uplifting music, and I'm probably gonna listen to some trap music after this. That's just me.
Brown shoes, then tell your soul for them to pay attention. Fuck all that plan. Now I'm grown. I pull
up. I put Moscato on. Hey.
One from one, say up. Shoot at an OB, shoot at a cop, shoot at the police, shoot at your top. I made a million on stop. Tell me I was by the bar. She like, hello. She rolled up on me.
I was rolling on a cigarello. I hate when people don't freaking scoot up, and it's like you behind them and you're trying to get your order, but they won't scoot up. It's kind of annoying. Like, girl, that was just the dumbest thing ever. But I'm about to order my granny something. Hello? Yes, I would like a mixed chicken and a medium fry. Yes. That is all. Alrighty. Something wrong with the that system. I could barely hear. Come on, black people, let's get it. Let's get it together. Let's go. But yeah, I'm like, maybe I got road rage or something, but it just pisses me off when you're at the drive-thru and people won't just scoot up just that little bit. Just scoot up just a little bit so I can go, so I can order. Like me, I pulled up almost, I'm not touching you, but I'm pretty close because the person behind me can order instead of waiting. So I'm about to get this McDonald's and bring that to my granny since that's what she wanted. And I'll be back. So I can show me later. This is your McDonald's right here.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm.
So we got grandmother with us. You know, I was vlogging just now. I was vlogging.
Huh?
I was vlogging.
Oh, were you?
Yeah. You know what vlogging is, Brandon? It's when you be making videos and putting them on YouTube.
Oh, okay.
That's my dream job.
What's funny, Granny?
You talking about your one of your what?
My dream job is to be on...
Your dream job.
Is to be a YouTuber.
Is it for real?
On everything I love. No, not yet. Here, record for me.
Huh?
Record for me.
What to, what's recording? What to do?
Aim the camera.
Aim it at you?
Yep.
I can't see.
You can't see this picture, Granny?
Okay, I see you now.
Wow.
Look through here, right?
Do you look on the screen too?
Oh, okay. It's a dollar store.
That's funny. You funny, Granny.
So, Jane, you gotta wash it. Sterilize it. Kinda
need one of these for my dishes. These are like, it's that Brillo, but it's kind of like the soft type of Brillo pads. I'll probably get one of these for my kitchen. Got my notebook. I need it to write my stuff in. Then I'm gonna get a board so we can do the vision board. And oh my God, I didn't know it had all this makeup on it. Yeah, I think I'm gonna get a big old board like this to do my vision board. I want a vision board for my personal life, plus I want one for my business. So I think I need one like this. I wish they had another one.
I will.
So I'm gonna get this for now. This is why I love going to my granny house, because I just be going in here and getting leftovers. Probably gonna heat this up and heat some of these greens up. Might take them to go. This is what I like about going to your granny's house, is because you, 9 times out of 10, you leaving with the Thanksgiving meal. So I don't want the McDonald's down the street. I'm waiting to see what the leftovers is inside your house. I got me some greens, chicken, red beans and rice, yams. Come on now. So I'm about to dig into this. This light will help me with my makeup, Granny. I need this light. Can I borrow it for a week? Why?
What am I gonna use?
The ceiling light. You not gonna do that for me? Well, Granny, I don't know. It's not really Christian light. Okay. Yeah, I like this light right here. I'm leaving my granny's place and it's dark at night. And literally every time I come over here, I be over here for hours. I thought I was just gonna be over here for like maybe an hour and then I was gonna be able to run my errands, but she wanted me to stay later. So I stayed and that's cool, but I gotta work early in the morning. So I'm not able to do the vision board that I wanted to do today, which is cool because now I don't have to rush and do it.
my vision board in the middle. I got young and saved because ideally that's what I want to be. I want to be young and saved. This is like how I would like my hair to look, you know, just put together and just taking pride in how my appearance. Then I got Shine So Bright, It Burns Their Eyes. Then I have this. This is kind of like my style. I would like cozy, comfortable type of style. Yes, I need to see it so I can hold myself to that standard, you know, and value myself. Also, fitness is something that I would like to get really, really a grip of. Music. This is my music side. I love music. I love creating music. So I want to get in that studio. I want to work on my fitness. I want to be saved. I want to work on my relationship with God. This is like a house, like goals, you know. Then it right here, it says talk to the hand. Another picture of Sweetie in the studio. Love to see it. Then let's go over here. Over here we got let's go right here. Only two moves this year: planning and making money, you know, manifestation, all that good stuff. And like, I'm a billionaire, keep on seeing that, keep on believing it. Taking trips with a, you know, a good friend, being successful, buying a great beautiful home, hitting 15,000 subscribers on YouTube is a goal this year. Focusing on where you want to go, not on what you fear, which is very, very like something I need to see, because I be fearing like starting a business or taking different things seriously or stepping out on faith. So this is something I like, this like VHS theme. So I just got that as a feel. Then right here it says, you're not reading this by accident. This is your confirmation. You're going to make it no matter what it looks like right now. God is going to renew your faithfulness. So hold on, be strong, and don't give up. You are next in line for a miracle. Then I have multiple incomes because, honey, that's what we're trying to do. We're trying to create multiple incomes. Right here, I got the, oh, shoot, girl. Girl, hold on. So, right here, this right here says, like, I am healthy, kind, generous, multimillionaire. Got the money, all that good stuff. I feel like this was cute. It's in my bathroom, so in the morning, whenever I'm getting ready, I can look over here and I can see, like, ooh, sis, hold yourself accountable. Do something to your hair. You know, like, read your Bible. Like, you know, manage your relationship with God. Don't give up. The blessing is going to come. Like, don't give up. Plan. Affirmations. You know, just doing the blueprint and then putting action and seeing the results. I want to hit that 15,000 subscribers. I'm not going to give up on YouTube. I'm not going to have fear stop me from this. From this. From all of this. You know? So this is my vision board. So right now I am about to go to work, honey, and I'm trying to see if I have time to cast my vote. It is 9:51. Actually, hold on. What time is it? I would get there at 9:51 and I gotta be at work at 10:30. So I'm thinking, depending on the line and stuff, I'll get there and I probably wouldn't leave until 10:20. So I'm just trying to debate if I have time to go vote today. But if you are like of age, if you are a citizen, I urge you to go vote. If you're watching this and it already has passed, I just want to tell you, like, next time, next election, your local elections and stuff, try to get informed. Like, I'm about to Google some stuff on the different candidates before I go vote. And I'm gonna go vote because my ancestors fought for me to go vote, and why not? Like, you're a part of this world, you're a part of this system. Go vote, go participate, and show up and show out. And you know what? That's on period.
You made it to the end of this video. That's what's up. Go ahead and like it, subscribe, and let's watch another video.